going off the rails, as I sometimes do on this show, because this is just what happens near the end of the season. And I'm still going because I'm trying to remember what we're doing. Okay, if you've never seen this segment before, I'm going to give the guys a theme or a storyline or a stat, and they are going to tell me if it's a major or minor issue heading into tonight's game number 6. We will start with the Sharks and Martin Jones, a perfect 4-0 in elimination games this postseason. Is the Sharks' ability to perform with their backs against the wall this postseason, will it have a major or minor influence on tonight's game? Can they draw on that?
Well, I'd have to say major, because they better draw on it. Because I don't know what else they're going to be drawing on with guys hurt down in the lineup. And, you know, they didn't really play very well in game 5. So I do think that's something that they will feed off a little bit in the run up to the game. So I'm okay with saying major there.
I'm going to go minor. Every game has a different beast. Every elimination game is different in its own scenario. They had that 5-minute major where they scored 4 power play goals. If you want major, that was major.
They could use a major tonight.
This game, a whole different scenario. Yes. Banged up. So I'm going to go with a minor. Impact. Right. This is just actually another game and another chance game for them to get by.
Spoken like a true former player. That's just another game.
Yeah, that's another
one game at a time.
Another
play
game.
A full 60.
Yeah. Nukalush, the standard answer.
That's right.
All right. How about
God willing.
How about this one? The Sharks have just 1 5-on-5 goal since game 3 and are having a little trouble finding their offense. Is San Jose's inability to get in front of the net and create havoc, as Billy alluded to earlier in the show on his tape, is that a major or minor issue heading into tonight's game for the Sharks?
That's a major issue. That is a major issue. You've got to get to the front of the net and make his life more difficult. So, major.
It's absolutely major. Yeah. One of the best deflection teams in the league. Yeah. They haven't been able to get those tip goals, those back to the D.
Yeah.
They've only had those 2 goals where they've worked it back to the
low
D.
Low to high.
Where they work it low and up to high.
And get the
so
shot.
So they've got to get there and find a way. And all those guys are good. Pavelski, if he's in the lineup, one of the best in the business. But they haven't been able to do that. Binnington is seeing pucks.
Yeah.
And he sees pucks. That's major, because that is San Jose's identity.
Yeah.
And if they can't get to that identity, they won't win.
Okay. How about this one? The fourth line for St. Louis has scored a goal in 4 straight games. Is the fourth line a major or minor factor, not just tonight, but against the Boston Bruins, a team as deep as the Bees, should the Blues advance to the Cup final?
Well, you can give this line any number you want, 4, 3, 88, whatever you want to do. They've been having an impact on the games, and they've been having a big impact. So I'm going to say major. And if they do win tonight and they end up against the Boston Bruins in the Stanley Cup final, think about the matchup of fourth lines there. That Sean Corrali fourth line in Boston has been great. And this one with Sundquist and Steen and Barbashev. Barbashev has been terrific. Mm-hmm. So I say it's a major one.
It's a major one, too. And you got the veteran Steen that has gone down onto that line and accepted that role and really taught.
Not easy
young
to do,
guys,
right?
No, when you've been in the league that long and you got to accept that fourth line role. But he's taken advantage of it, and he's brought these young players along, Sundquist, and they're both good at both ends of the rink. You touch on that other line where you have Achari, and then you got Corrali, and then you got Nordstrom, the other kid. Wagner's banged up. But that when Bruce Cassidy's playing at home, he plays that fourth line against the other team's top lines. Yeah. Same thing with Berube. I feel that
he starts those guys a lot.
And they scored the first goal in the last couple of games.
Yeah.
So those are major factors for not only St. Louis, but Boston.
Yeah,
those fourth lines have been good for both of those teams.
Yeah. I love good fourth lines.
Depth.
We talk about it every year. It almost sounds cliche. Talking about depth is so important in the playoffs, but it just keeps turning out to be true every single year.
Yes, it is.
Okay, Boston, though, dealing with those 10 full days off. Nobody's really talking about this, right?
Yeah.
Kidding. No. The Bruins have 10 days off. They're going to hold that scrimmage on Thursday. Do you think that'll have a major or minor impact on how things play out in game 1 of the Stanley Cup final?
Minor for me. I think it's major for the Boston Bruins Foundation, because they're going to make $20 a pop
and
put that towards really good causes. So you Bruins fans, get out there, support your team and support that charity. I think it's a great idea to try to do something like that with all this time off. But I think at the end of the day, I mean, this is just, you know, it's minor. You got to play games. They're going to be
hitting.
Minor
game
for me. Billy Lindsay, weigh in here, please.
It's minor.
Thank you.
Just go out there. Whenever you're on the ice, when you have this kind of break and you got time, if you're out there 20 minutes, 30 minutes, full bore. 100%. Maybe a scrimmage at night, get your body set. Say, come for meetings in the morning, have a meal, take your nap, kind of get set to that routine.
Body clock.
But whatever you do when you're on the ice, just go. Make it short and say, hey, listen, there's no lollygagging out here. We got to just put our foot on the pedal for the time we're on the ice because that's the way you're going to have to play. But these guys are veterans. Once you drop that puck and you got all that energy just ramping through your body, just your natural instincts are going to take over, aren't they? And game one of the
season. You know better than me.
I think you're going to, for this one series, rest is good. And I believe once you get back into it, all those emotions and all those instincts just come back like that.
All right. Do you think there's a slight benefit if the Blues close out this Western Conference final tonight? Because then the Blues will also have, 6 days off, if my math's right, 5 days off.
Yeah, I mean, I think it changes the dynamic of the discussion that we have at the end of the day, because they'll have several days off as well.
It sort of balances it.
A little bit more, yeah.
Okay.
I think the Bruins would love to see the Blues win tonight.
Okay.
Get that over with. Yeah.
Okay. Well, we talked about the scrimmage being good for the charitable reasons, obviously. So tell us a little bit about the Liberty Bell Games, because that's a good cause, too.
Yes, it's our friends at Liberty Bell Games. The time is coming again. The 11th annual Liberty Bell Games, sponsored by the good folks at Wendy's and the New Jersey Devils. Great to see them sponsoring again. It's a showcase tournament, 120 players ages 15 through 17 at the Red Bank Armory, which is a terrific rink in Red Bank, New Jersey. 180 of the alumni currently playing or committed to U.S. college hockey programs. You might know some of those names at the bottom. Johnny Gaudreau, Kevin Bank playing tonight. They played in this, and it's players from the Mid-Atlantic Southeast region. And you can see this year they're going to have a charity component, and the teams will be playing for these following charities. And you can go to libertybells.com and find out how to make a contribution. You can contribute to the individual teams. And then at the end, as they have the tournament plays out June 7th through 9th, the team that wins will have the most money to contribute to their charity, and it'll move down from there. But it's a great tourney every year, a great opportunity to see some good hockey. It's free. Go out to Red Bank, New Jersey. Check it out. Liberty Bell Games, June 7th through 9th, sponsored by Wendy's and the Devils.